we're going to be talking about the top three features that I dislike the most about simplified.co. Feel free to click the chapters in the description to jump, but make sure to stick around to the end for a special bonus. So let's get started. All right, so Simplified has a lot of cool features that make it stand out from their competitors, but there are some features that are not ready for prime time just yet. So the first feature that I dislike about this tool is their search function. It doesn't always work the way that it should. So for example, you can search under templates, you can find anything in this search bar, or at least that's what you think you can do. But if you just search for anything, it just keeps loading and loading and loading. I searched for water, thinking that could be a common thing, but it just keeps loading and nothing happens. Let me search for furniture. It just keeps loading. I'm not sure if it's just a speed issue or if there's an issue with their system. I was searching for money earlier today. It wasn't working, but then I searched for it again a few hours later and it did work. So let me try again. I'm gonna search for money. Okay, now it does work. So you can see all the money related templates. Just let me search for Instagram. Let's see if that will show anything. Yeah, it's not showing up anything if I search for Instagram, which is really weird. So sometimes their search feature doesn't always work. So you will be, for the most part, for most cases, you would have to be just searching, scrolling down, looking for the dimensions that you want, and then clicking on the view all, and then just looking for the template that best suits your needs. All right. So the second feature that I dislike is the fact that it could be pretty buggy. Okay, for example, not all the templates will load up the right way. So just let me click on this one. All right, see the guy here? He didn't pop up. All right, and this happens for a lot of the templates. So let me go to templates again and just let me click on this one. All right, so you see how it looks like. I'm just gonna click on that. Let's see if this works. Yeah, see, so the majority of the template didn't load. So, or actually now there's a guy. It could be a speed issue, but who knows? And sometimes when you try to update the font and make it like bold, or yeah, you see how this is Poppins, it's bold, but that's not Poppins. Let me unbold it. This is Poppins. I know that because I use Poppins quite a bit. Let me highlight and bold it again. Okay, now it works. So it's a little buggy, you know, so keep that in mind. And also when you download the file, it downloads really weird. So I was actually designing my YouTube thumbnail, and let me show you that thumbnail really quick. Let me go to my projects and pull it up so you can see exactly how I wanted it to be designed. So, okay, so it doesn't even look, so I opened the thumbnail that I created and it doesn't look anything like this. It's completely jumbled up. Let me go back. Let me show you. So it should be looking like this. You see this? It should have been looking like this. But when I downloaded it, this is how it looks like. So let me pull it up here. So it turned out like this. So from this, you see on the right, to this. So the logo is like that. There's red. And then the background is not correct. It just looks really bad. So I couldn't use this thumbnail because it didn't download properly. So let me open it again. Yeah, see, it's still not loading properly. So that's buggy. The third feature that I dislike about the tool is this left sidebar. All right, so the way they organize it more specifically. So for visuals, they bucket it by arrows, animals, weather, buildings, which is nice. And then you can search anything you want, right? So if I search for box, different icons of boxes. Now with components, I'm trying to figure out how the components differ from the visuals, right? Because these look like icons as well. And let me see, if I search for box, for whatever reason, these show up, but I'm not sure if these are boxes, honestly. Let me search for lines. Okay, these show up, not exactly what I was looking for, but I'm not sure exactly why under all components, why these are not under visuals, under icons, because these, they look like icons and they are icons, but for whatever reason, they split it into two separate sections in the left sidebar. So it's a little confusing. Not too fond of the way they kind of organize the elements under visuals and components. Just makes things a little bit harder to find and harder to figure out what elements you want to bring to your image. So it did take me a while to build out this YouTube thumbnail because I was kind of struggling between, you know, where to find the elements that I was looking for. So those are the three features that I dislike about the tool. I know this is a pretty new tool. There is a lot of room for improvement, and I'm very confident that the developers will improve it. But if you think these features are not a deal breaker, feel free to purchase this tool through my affiliate link. Now, if you do purchase through my affiliate link, I do want to offer you a bonus. Now, Simplified actually has quite a bit of really good resources in their blog, but there's over 100 resources and it's from 28 pages. So it will be very hard for you to kind of sift through the best ones. So what I did was I did the work for you and I found the top 10 best resources that comes from Simplified. So I created a checklist out of which is the top 10 design and copywriting resources that you can use. I'll send this checklist for free. If you want to learn more about how to use complementary colors, how to use their Instagram caption generator, or how to use their AI tool for essay writing, this is the checklist for you. Let me know, fill out the form, click the link to the form if you purchase the tool through my affiliate link. I'll verify on my end and I'll send you access to this checklist. So if you thought this video was helpful, definitely give it a thumbs up and I will see you in the next one. All right, if you want to continue to learn more about simplifed.co, click on this video to get a general review and demo of the entire tool, and click this video to learn about my top 3 favorite features of the tool. All right, I'll see you on the next one.